The aim of this video is to show you how to use Cite Them Right online. Cite Them Right online is a tool that we provide via the University Library to help you to format citations and reference list entries correctly. The features of this resource include examples of in-text citations and reference list entries for all of the referencing styles that are used at Staffordshire University. There's also general guidance articles on how to cite and reference, a basics guide, there are tutorials and videos. This video is going to show you how to find Cite Them Right online, and how to use it for each of the different referencing styles that are used at the university: Harvard, APA 7th, OSCOLA and IEEE. The quickest way to access Cite Them Right online is via using the referencing guidance link on the library homepage. This takes you to the ref zone, where you can select the right style that your subject needs. And from there, you will find a link to Cite Them Right online. If you are on campus, this will log you in straight away. If you are off campus, you will need to log in via your institution. So to help you understand referencing, there is a basics of referencing section with lots of little articles helping you to develop your referencing skills, as well as a section on understanding plagiarism. There is a Cite Them Right tutorial and a number of videos answering questions that you might have. Next, I'll show you how to use Cite Them Right online to help you with Harvard referencing style. Choose Harvard, and then you'll see a menu at the top with all the different kinds of sources that you might need to use in your academic study. Each section has a range of different options, and if we click on a resource, it then gives us a citation order. Use this as a checklist to make sure you've got all the information you need, and then it gives you examples of what the in-text citation and the reference list should look like for this style. The You Try box allows you to overwrite the prompts with the formatting all in place. You don't need to remember the punctuation or the italics. All of that's there for you. Just overwrite with the information that you need to put in. You can then copy the reference and paste it into alphabetical order into your reference list. There are links on each page to give you some guidance and a tutorial about how to use the You Try box. To cover the most commonly needed sources, you can find how to cite web pages, journal articles, newspaper articles, UK legislation, and government department publications. On the main menu page, there is also guidance to help you set out your citations, what to include in your list, etc. This section will show you how to use Cite Them Right Online for APA 7th style. So the first page is a menu with all the different kinds of resources you might need. There is a general guidance section on the right hand side. And then you can work through the resources. So if we look first at printed books, it gives you a citation order, followed by an example of an in-text citation and a reference list. And then it shows you an example in the You Try box. You can now overwrite these prompts with the information from the book that you are citing. You don't need to remember the punctuation, where the italics go. You don't need to remember to put the indent in on the second line. It's all there for you. And then you can copy it and paste it into alphabetical order into your reference list. There is more links to guidance on the left-hand side of each page. And there is a page for all the common things that you're going to need to cite. So websites, journal articles, newspaper articles, Acts of Parliament in the UK, and publications from government departments. This section is going to demonstrate Cite Them Right Online for checking OSCOLA references. So you first of all have a list of all the different kinds of resources you might need to cite. We'll start looking at books. So you've got a citation order list, and then examples of your footnotes, and then what that looks like in the bibliography. You have a You Try box for both, so that you can overwrite these prompts. And the formatting is in there already for you, the italics, the brackets, the full stops, etc. You can then copy that once you've overwritten it and put it into your bibliography. At the side of each page, there is an OSCOLA guidance section where you can click the links to find out more. And looking at some other resources you might need, we've got journal articles, web pages, newspaper articles, of course, if you're using OSCOLA, you are going to be a law student, so the legal section is going to be most important to you, where there are options to choose a range of different legal documents, including official records of Parliament, and then the same for international material. So to look at law reports, case law, for example, there is guidance here. and Acts of Parliament. And on the general page for OSCOLA, you have some general guidance links on the right-hand side to help you to format your citations and references. This part of the video is going to show you how to use Cite Them Right Online for IEEE references. So the menu shows us all the different types of resources that you can choose from. We've got general guidance on the right-hand side, and then we can select the different individual resource types. Start with printed books. There are examples for the different numbers of authors. There's an exam reference example, and then a U-try box, which you can overwrite with the correct information for the source you are citing, which you can then copy once you've put that in place. The punctuation is all there for you. The title is already in italics. The commas and the colons and the full stops are already in place. You don't need to remember where those go. There is a page for journal articles. Page for web pages. Newspaper articles. And protocols, regulations, and guidelines. Each page has links to guidance on the left-hand side to help you as well. In summary, it is possible to use Cite Them Right Online to check your in-text citations are correct systematically for each different source type, and to check your reference list entries are correct as well. It doesn't matter what kind of source you're using, there will be a way to show you how to do that on Cite Them Right. There is a search bar at the top. If you can't find it in the menu, type the resource type into the search box. Make sure you've clicked the type of referencing style that you need so that you're not doing that incorrectly. But once you've done that, you will be able to see the example for that source type. On the right-hand side, we have a quote from a Level 6 nursing student from 2023 who said that once they started using Cite Them Right Online, the comments that they used to get about their references from their markers in their assignments stopped completely, demonstrating that this is a way that you can get your citations and references absolutely correct so that you can focus on the content in your assignments. For more information about citations and referencing, explore the Ref Zone, where you can book a just referencing appointment for specific guidance on your citations and referencing.